Hello, my name is Lucky Mayo, and welcome back to Phoenix Wright Justice for All in the Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney Trilogy. I'm alone this time. Alan's at home. Whew, that was a close one. I know you were giving it your all to defend me, but I could feel the death penalty hanging in the air. I felt like I was pretty close to dying myself. But you were wonderful out there! You listened carefully, made theories, and tricked everyone into believing you. Thanks. Wait, tricked? That must be the lawyer's secret technique, right? By the way, is the next witness who I think it is? Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's a lot of heart. Guess there's no escaping her, huh? Remember, Nick, you promised you'd save me. If you lose, me and my sister's ghost will come after you and haunt you.
Your sister? Are you talking about Mystic Mia?
Yeah, do you remember her, Pearly? My sister was a super good lawyer. She was also Nick's teacher.
Oh, I didn't know that.
She's adorable. Mm-hmm. That was a good muffin. Now the layout of that is very confusing. Fort will now reconvene. Now, the first order of— God damn. I don't want to hear it, old man. After I call my witness, sit there quietly and watch like a good little boy.
Yes, sir.
Bring in the photographer who witnessed the channeling. God damn it, Lotta.
Witness, your name and occupation, if you please.
Hi, Phoenix. How you doing?
Just fine. Sorry about this. Didn't exactly have a choice, you know?
Yowza!
Name and occupation. She does not play.
I declare what in tarnation?
Hey, Judge, this here is against my bans against my fair self. That's fine.
That's fine. That ain't fine. That's a whip. Yeah.
There's no need for foolish outcries from foolishy foolish fools. Just hurry up and testify about what happened on the day of the murder. I haven't even gotten to say my name and job yet. My name's Lotta Hart, paranormal photographer, and I'm here to testify. Now, let's all be one big happy family, okay? That poor fucking judge. Okay, witness's account. Only the doc and the defendant went into the channeling chamber. We were waiting outside the door, and then bang, we hear this gunshot. Mr. Lawyer there broke the door down, and we rushed into the room. Inside was a dead victim and a defendant, waving a pistol around. I swear, other than those two, there was no one else in the room. And did you take a picture of the scene right after the murder took place? She did. Because she's fucking a lot of heart. Reckon course! Reckon court? Excuse me? Reckon course. It's short for you reckon? Of course I did. Does it look like I care? She does not fucking play. Just hurry up and show your picture to the court. The moment of truth. What will be in that picture? Let's see here. This here's the picture. It was certainly seen that only the defendant and the victim were in that room. Yep. Lotta's photo added to the court record. Fucking Lotta. Are you ready, Mr. Phoenix Wright? Excuse me. I will clear all doubt about Maya through this cross-examination. Just watch me. Witness's account. Muffin. Sorry, muffin.
Hold it!
It was really all those two that went in.
Objection!
What are you blabbering about? You were there too, weren't you not? Why don't you answer that yourself? Was it really just the two of them? Yes, Dr. Gray and Maya were the only two that went into the room. Well, hold on, we can't have the defense testifying against its own client.
Anyway, folks, only two of them went to the piano chamber. You knew that from the beginning, didn't you, witness? Continue.
Hold it!
Was it really a gunshot?
Objection!
Fuck, man. Are you insane? You must have heard it as well. Air 2. How'd you testify for the court, Mr. Phoenix, right? Was it really a gunshot? Yes, I think that it was something that sounded like a gunshot. And why are we here listening to the defense testify? And the world becomes just a little crueler. I heard a gunshot a long time ago, so now I'm gonna tell you that was a gunshot I heard. Now, this is where the story heats up. Why am I pressing everything? So let me get this straight. This Mr. Lawyer there broke the door down. Honestly, Mr. Phoenix, right? Why don't you tell us what happened, man? Yes, Miss Von Karma. I broke the door down. Sorry. Why does this feel like an inquisition? No need for apologizing. That was great. You're a real man. Oh, really? That's something I would have liked to see. The judge is smiling rather openly. I think that's a good sign. And what did you see once you broke in? Inside it was a dead victim and the defendant waving a pistol around. Why do I have to press everything?
Hold it!
Are you sure it was the defendant, Maya Fey? Sure, I'm sure. Lotta seems awfully confident in her testimony. Press harder. Lotta, please, think back to that day one more time. What's you getting at? Remember what you said when we broke into the room? Great. Flashbacks. I was murdered. Lotta, at a time like this? Times like this are perfect for snapping up shots. But anyway, what's going on here? This gal, she... Maya? And you saw the murderer at that time. You couldn't even tell if it was Maya Fey or not, am I correct? Well, you see... Or, Miss Hart, you were here to present accurate testimony. Bitch. Where the fuck did my charger go? Shit, my phone's gonna die. I don't need it. Sorry. Good, this shifts things back to my side. For a defense lawyer, your defense is terribly lacking, Mr. Phoenix. Why are you gonna use my name? Witness, think back to when those two entered the channeling chamber. When they entered? One of those people that entered the chamber was Maya Fey, correct? Yeah, that's right. Yeah, it was Maya that went in. Looks like we've come to a conclusive conclusion. I'm always eating now. The person in this picture is most certainly Maya Fey. Exactly. Rats, now I'm trapped like one. Again.
Hold it!
Are you absolutely certain of that? Sure am, but that old witch chases out the room, so... Old witch. Does she mean Morgan Fey, Mystic Morgan? But there was no one else in there, and you know it. The channeling chamber was very dark, almost pitch black. Was there really no one else in there? What about behind the folding screen? Did you check back there? Wreck given. Fucking... What in the... Wreck given, you know? You reckon? That's a given. Took me a good look around the room once. There ain't no way anyone was hanging out behind that folding screen. If I may have a word with you, Miss Hart. What? You got a problem? Rhett Given, I am having a little difficulty in understanding you. You stop saying I was fucking reading that, bitch. Now then, Mr. Phoenix Wright, do you see a problem with the testimony or don't you? I was with her, so I know she's telling the truth. I gotta choose, can't present anything yet. victim, Dr. Turner Gray, and the defendant, Maya Fey. Hey, that all rhymed. The face of the defendant cannot be verified in this picture. However, if we think about the circumstance, it would have to be the defendant. What am I going to do if I just let this go? What is it, Mr. Wright? You look as if you have something to say. If I make one wrong move, I'm gonna have to judge against me. Is there anything I can present that would prove it's not mine in the photo? Can't present anything yet. Well, Mr. Wright, nothing, Your Honor. That's very smart of you, Mr. Phoenix. Why do you gotta put the Mr. there? You really should give up trying to prove this is not Maya Fey. I didn't say anything about giving up. I just don't have the right piece of evidence to prove for my argument. That's enough! Is this it? Is this all I could do? I think it's quite obvious to this court that a verdict of not guilty is not possible. I told you. Totally, 100%, impossible. Ms. Von Karma, do you have any further questions for this witness? Having established the defendant's guilt, further questioning won't be needed. What about the defense? No further questions, I presume? I couldn't protect my... The defense... Phoenix, you can't make that kind of face! A lawyer is someone who smiles no matter how bad it gets. Mia. Pearly! I guess I made it just in time, wouldn't you say? But pearls. Her clothes are a bit small. Anyway, what are you waiting for, Phoenix? Let's go. But how? She's already taken away every advantage. The advantage is still in your hand. Think carefully, one more time, about what you saw in the channeling chamber. Do you remember what you told me yesterday? Dr. Gray! Fucking Lada, dude. I was murdered. What? Lada, at a time like this? Times like this, forever snapping up shots. You see, there is one final piece to this puzzle. Mia. Question Lada one more time, Phoenix. I don't know if she's doing it unconsciously or on purpose, but she's not testifying truthfully. Now then, this court would like to end the cross-examination. Please wait, Your Honor. The defense would like to request that the witness testify one more time. Overruled. I'm afraid you're too late, Mr. Wright. The cross-examination has already ended. Furthermore, any unrelated questions? It's fine. I'll allow another testimony. Avon Karma's case is perfect. Absolutely flawless. And what better time than this for you to see that? Let's see, I beat your dad. I mean, I have some place I must go after this. Alright, I'll allow it. Miss Hart, hurry up and give us another testimony. Well, heck. What am I supposed to talk about? Please tell us once more what happened when you burst into the channeling chamber. Okay, you got it. See? You got through to the judge somehow, right? Well, actually, it was Von Karma's whip that got through to him. When we broke into that room, all I could focus on was mine. I was kind of scared of the dead body, so I didn't take a good look at it. I'm really bad when it comes to blood and ghosts and stuff, but I still managed to point my camera at Maya and take a shot. Nothing sounds different from before. Some parts of her testimony were very vague. I should press her on those sections. Struggle all you like as you taste the bitterness of your defeat. Well, amuse me with your useless questions, Mr. Phoenix, right? I'm waiting. Alright, I need to, press her on her last statement.
Hold it!
Two, right? Two what? Two shots. You took two shots. But only one has been submitted as evidence. Miss Hart, where is the other picture you've been withholding? No, you got it all wrong. It's not me. I didn't mean anything bad. I know I can be a little mean, but I ain't evil. Well, at least she knows herself. Then why have you not shown this other picture to the court yet? Well, ain't it obvious? That prosecutor woman told me to shut my trap about it. What? On Karma! Miss Von Karma, you're hiding critical evidence! Unforgivable, Von Karma. suppressing evidence like this, you're as bad as your father. I wanted to confront her, but I'll leave it to the judge. I'm so mad that even my throat's clenching up. I'd better let the judge handle this. Miss Von Karma, would you care to explain yourself to this court? I thought this picture was not important, and thus felt no need to submit it, that's all. How could you think? The pictures were more or less the same, so why bother with the second? I mean, it's just so much more trouble than it's worth for me to submit this as evidence. More trouble than it's worth? How can you say that? If you want to see it that badly, I'll submit it. She was actually pretty chill. I liked her. Lotta's photo to a picture taken at the murder scene. What is this picture? It's obviously the second picture the witness took that day at the scene of the crime. Well, it's a little off-center, but that's what you get with a nervous amateur. I think the important point here is the person in this picture. This is most definitely not Maya Fey. What is the meaning of this? This might be the break I was looking for. Now, should I not insist that the person in this picture is not Maya? It's no good. We've been through this so many times. This is not like you, Mr. Wright. Why are you not objecting? The person in this photo is clearly not the defendant, and yet... There's no way he can raise an objection and hope to live. Explain yourself! Your Honor, I would like for you to take a look at this picture. Where the fuck did you get this picture? This was taken yesterday at the detention center's visitor room. This is Mr. Phoenix Wright and the defendant, Maya Fey, during his visit. Maya Fey? But isn't this a totally different person? She looks this way because she is obviously in the middle of channeling a spirit. It's unbelievable that she can... Yet, it is the truth. Maya Fey is in that state, she physically changes into the person she's called. Miss Von Karma, a word if I may. Mia? Taking pictures of someone during a private visit is illegal. Surely you must know that picture can't be submitted as evidence. Obviously I know this picture is illegal, but I never intended to submit it as evidence in the first place. But what is she... From the moment I showed this picture to the court, the case became all mine. After all, this image has now been forever burned into the judge's mind. I don't have even a single witty line. It looks like we've been had. I don't claim to understand this, and I still cannot believe it. Are you saying that this person is the defendant, Maya Fey? If I give up here, the trial will end. But if I slip up and say something wrong, it'll cost me. Is there any way I can prove that the person in this picture is not Maya? I can prove it. No, buddy! Fuck! No! Wait! Stop! Damn it! Fuck! I fucked up! Lies a critical contradiction to all the testimony up until now. What is it now, Mr. Wright? Fuck. Please let me explain. So, you think you've spotted a problem with this picture? Then earn your keep. I gotta point out the left sleeve.
Take that!
Please direct your attention here. To the sleeve, but there isn't anything odd about it. And that is exactly what is so odd. Something that should be there is suddenly missing. Should be there. Shiga knows what I'm getting at. There was a bullet hole in the sleeve of the defendant's costume. If that's the case, then it should be in this picture as well. Miss Von Karma, you intended to hide this valuable piece of evidence. You will most certainly be assigned a penalty for this. Alright, this should do some major damage to her argument. Don't celebrate yet. You like to bring down the mood, don't you? Take a look at Miss Von Karma's face. Ah, she's got that condescending grin plastered all over her face again. Jumping the gun again, I see. Your Honor. I'd like to extend an apology on behalf of those incompetent fools. What do you mean? And what incompetent fools? If those fools down at the precinct hadn't missed the bullet hole, I would have gotten a report about it. As I didn't, I could not have known that this picture had was any of any value to the case. I see. She's lying through her teeth. I know it. That woman knew about everything. The bullet hole, the picture, everything. But you can't prove that. Franziska von Karma's idea of a perfect case is quite fascinating, don't you think? Your Honor, you need not worry. If you must assign a penalty, I'll personally make sure that detective gets what's coming. I'm sure there'll be a great gnashing of teeth at his next salary discussion. Poor Gumshoe! In any case, this is a very big problem. The defendant was taken into custody, her costume had a bullet hole in its sleeve. However, from this photo, it would appear that right after the shooting, there was none. The judge is confused by this strange twist of events. This is your chance, Phoenix. Hold all you've got into this one shot, alright? Got it. Watch this, Maya. Your Honor! There's only one logical explanation for the contradiction. The shooter is someone else. The defendant's sleeve had a bullet hole in it. However, this person clearly does not. There can be only one explanation. The person who shot Dr. Gray was not the defendant, but a different person altogether. What? I know. I'm shocked, too. Order! 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 If order is not restored, I will suspend this trial. Ow! Ah! Why me? The defense's argument is a complete mess! A complete mess. I fail to see how. Please enlighten us. Hey, witness! Ah! What the heck? Is that any way to ask a gal a favor? Be quiet, you! You were the one who said it was the only two of them when you entered the room. Well, you know, if you were lying, I swear that my whip will be the last thing you see. Look, sis, you're looking mighty scary, so why don't we say you? Why? I swear I wasn't lying or nothing. There wasn't anyone else in there, honest. See? Now, remember this, Mr. Phoenix, right? Where did the defendant vanish to? And where did this other woman appear from? Why is it lately that all I want to do is cry? Well, if the person in this picture is not the defendant, then this poses two very big questions. First, where did the defendant manage to? And second, where did this person come from? That's right. Now hurry up and answer, Mr. Phoenix, right? Come on, we can't fall apart here, Phoenix. Can't believe that even Mia's calling me by my full name. But I mean, how am I supposed to prove something like this? Had enough yet, Mr. Phoenix, right? Or do you think you have enough in you to turn things around even now? To turn things around? That's right. Mia would always turn things around and change her perspective. Phoenix? So where did this intruder appear and from, and where did Maya disappear to? I need to look at this situation from a different angle. Let's see. What if before we broke in, the third person was already in the room? And what if Maya had left that room somehow? If I could prove that either one of those conditions were true... Mr. Wright, let's hear what you've come up with. I think what happened before we forced our way into the channeling chamber is... Maya had left the room. I gotta choose that, right? Maya had left the channeling chamber at some point, and the defense can prove this. Oh? How a foolish fool makes a foolish face while dreaming foolishly foolish dreams. Maya Fey was being looked after by her aunt, Morgan Fey. The chances of her leaving that crime scene is lower than that detective's salary. Poor Gumshoe. Anyway, let's see some evidence. Prove that from the murder until the time of arrest, the defendant had left the room.
Take that!
Miss Hart, do you remember this key? Well, I've seen it.
Hey, that's the channeling chamber key, right?
Before the channeling started, Maya locked the door from the inside with that. The defendant herself locked the door.
Yeah, that's why we all couldn't get the door open.
That key's the only one of its kind, after all.
Oh, one of a kind, you say?
Wait, Mr. Phoenix, right?
Yes, it looks like she's catching on.
I'm afraid to ask, but why is that key currently in your possession?
Uh-huh, what do you mean?
If Maya Faye locked herself in, then the key should have been with her.
Yes, agreed.
However, she did not have the key at the time of her arrest.
Well, ain't that a key?
So how come you're holding it?
I got this as a present from a certain little girl. And that little girl was nowhere near the crime scene at the time.
That's preposterous.
That means that Maya Faye must have left the room. If she had not, then I would not be holding this key you see before you.
Hell yeah.
It seems we have come to an impasse. This picture has clearly captured the face of the murderer. However, is this person the defendant or not? The defense is arguing that this person is not the defendant. Furthermore, as proof, this key has been submitted as evidence. Miss Von Karma,
how can this be?
At this point in time, a verdict on the defense's guilt is not possible. My perfect case! How is there a flaw in my perfect case?
Don't think you've won yet, Mr. Phoenix, right?
I'm a prodigy. I've never lost a case. And I don't intend to lose here in this courtroom to a fool like you. I don't care what I have to do. I will get my guilty verdict.
That's enough. If you would like to continue, do so in the lobby.
Court will reconvene tomorrow at 10 a.m.
That is all. Court is adjourned.
Hell yeah. June 21st, 1:32 p.m. District Court Defendant Lobby Number 3.
Wow! That was you, Pearly? You summoned my sis?
Yes, I felt I had no choice.
Great going, Pearly. I knew you were special.
Hey, Nick, did you know?
Yeah. It's not like anyone else in there could have done that.
Nick, I know you're trying to really harden all, but I really don't remember ever leaving that room.
And I don't think that a third person could have gone into that room.
Yeah.
Well, at least we have until tomorrow to figure things out. Like what happened in the room, for instance.
Yeah, I'm counting on you.
I envy the two of you. God damn it.
Oh, by the way, Nick,
do you think you could take Pearly back home for me?
Sure.
Alright, Pearls. You ready to go buy some tickets?
Huh?
A ticket? Poor thing. So sheltered.
I'm gonna end this episode here. Leave a like if you enjoyed. Please subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time. Till next time, my name is Lucky Mayo, and I'm signing off.